Hey troops, welcome to the channel. Gen Dead Commando here, and today we're going to be reacting to a video of the Ranger Battalion. Basically, we're getting like a guided tour, so to speak, of what it looks like, okay, for day-to-day staff and what the basically their work and office. All right, so we've learned quite a bit on these guys over the past couple of weeks and days. So yeah, I thought why not just do this video. Plus, it's a Sunday. We want a nice video to react to, and we can all have a nice cup of tea whilst we're doing it, troops, okay? Excuse me. But yeah, other than that, troops, we're just going to get straight into this one right after you've liked the video, subscribed to the channel, hitting the notifications, and the Discord, guys. The Discord is a fantastic community where like-minded individuals such as myself and all of you guys can chat. And we can suggest videos, talk to each other, and just in general have a nice, good, friendly time, okay? There's nothing but positivity that goes on there, troops. So, yeah, please join the Discord. But we're just going to get straight into this one. If you've got any questions, please drop them in the live Premier feed. And if you want to ask me something afterwards, drop a comment in or just message me on Discord. I'll gladly get back to you guys, all right? But, yeah, after this, we're going to go live on Twitch as well, I think. So Twitch is something that I'm really interested in, okay, just to keep the conversation going, because when you're doing a reaction video, you can only talk for so much time. But what I like to do is go live on Twitch afterwards. We can play some games, and I played with Art Ninjas yesterday, who's a moderator on the account. Me and him had some good fun. He's got a fantastic Twitch channel, so make sure you follow him as well. And yeah, we just had a good time, guys, and we can chat on about our military careers, or we can just have a conversation about whatever you want, really, and play some games. Doesn't get any better than that, does it, really? So yeah, please stick around for that, guys. But other than that, just let's enjoy this one, and I'll speak to you soon, guys.
Välkommen till Arméns jägarbataljon. Mitt namn är Filip Lundell. Jag är officer med graden Fenrik på Arméns jägarbataljon.
Right, so he's an officer. Does that mean he's an officer in the financial department, or has he got a financial degree and that's what he works in? I understand the translations in these videos are not great, okay, guys, especially the auto-translate, but it's better than nothing, all right, and we're going to make do with it. We've got some very, very talented and lovely individuals in the chat anyway who are going to probably translate some of the misdemeanors and mistakes anyway. You guys know who you are. Our moderators are fantastic people. Thank you all.
Den här filmen syftar till att ge dig som rekryt en första inblick i hur det ser ut här på AJB.
All right, so it's an insight as well. It's not just what it looks like. It's an insight into what goes on there potentially as well. So that's pretty interesting for people like myself who've never stepped foot in this area. Right, does that sign ring any bells to anyone? Has anyone seen that sign and thought, no, I've been there, it was horrendous, or it was good? What stories have you got behind that sign, guys? Let me know in the chat.
Nu befinner du dig på insidan utav skvadronens ingång. När du som rekryt är på kasern, alltså inte i fält, så är det väldigt viktigt att man är hel och ren och är representabel. Ett sätt att uppnå det är att till exempel spola.
I was going to say that was the entrance, but it looks a little bit like what we would call in the Royal Marines commandos an ablutions. And ablutions is basically where you would clean boots and kit and stuff like that. So yeah, I was a bit surprised when he said that's the entrance, but now that he's explained, it's obviously to make sure that you're clean and presentable before you get into the building. Yeah, it makes sense that they've got them in the beginning, at the beginning place. So
sina kängor och att putsa upp dem här. Går vi vidare. De få utbildningsdygn du inte kommer vara i fält kommer du påbörja din dag i en sån här korridor med en uppställning. Uppställningen gör vi för att ta närvarokontroll, kolla vilka som är sjuka och för att helt enkelt starta dagen.
That's pretty much how it starts in every military day, all right? You get a nominal role, as we would call it in the British military, and that's to account for who's there. And if you're not there, where are you? You're absent, you're definitely in trouble, all right, guys? So I think this is going to be a good little video as well for those who are aspiring to join the Swedish military and see what the Jäger Battalion looks like, okay? In fact, yeah, that is a real good thing. So if you're brand new to this channel, guys, and you haven't seen what we've been doing, we've been reacting to Jäger content, okay, on YouTube. And we've got a lot of people who are aspiring to actually join the military or are due to what's the word I'm looking for? You're conscripted, aren't you, into the military? So this will give a decent insight into that, I guess.
Vi ska nu gå in och titta på ett av de logement som ni ska bo på. Här kommer ni att förvara era saker i såna här skåp. In här.
Right, so when I was in commando training, I was in commando training. It was the kit that you get issued sometimes is a little old, and the, you know, the lockers and stuff are a little old. I'm guessing these haven't been changed as well in many, many years, guys, ranging from the guys who probably served way back when. If these look the same as when you were in, please drop me a comment. I want to see if these things have changed or not, because when it comes to the military, if it ain't broke, they're not going to fix it, if that makes sense. So, yeah.
Kommer du och dina kamrater dela på badrum och handfat samt dusch? Den lilla fritid ni kommer ha kommer ni bland annat kunna spendera här eller för att göra diverse kvällstjänst. Här sover ni. Och den här logementen är gjorda för 10 personer.
10 people accommodation, okay, so it is similar across Britain as well. You're going to share accommodation blocks with your fellow squaddies, your fellow military personnel. And that's done for a reason. It's not just to save on money for accommodation purposes. It's also to bring you all together. You're going to be working in close-knit teams together. And it's important that you build those relationships fast and those friendships fast. And the only way to do it is to live amongst each other, eat, sleep, repeat, you know. And you make some of the best friends in the military, okay? And it all starts in these places, these grubby little accommodations that aren't the best. Definitely nothing like home. The food might not be as good. But yeah, you'll make real good friendships. And we've said this before on the channel, guys. Those friendships are forged on arduous hardship. Simple as that. There's no way you can you can't get friendships nowhere near as strong when when that isn't present. I believe, I think, you know, look at all your friends in Civvy Street. Those of you who's been in the military, you love these people with all your heart. However, there's a different type of bond that you get with military personnel, you know, because you've been through stuff, you've struggled together, you know, and it's a very special friendship, and they're forged from these places.
Personer, och här kommer ni spendera de få nätter ni inte är i fält. Det här är militärrestaurang Dragonen och tillika värnpliktsmatsal. Här kommer ni att äta de dagar återigen som ni inte är i fält.
Excuse me. Sports hall, guys, that's where all of the fitness is going to be taking place, I guess.
Vi befinner oss nu i sporthallen. Det är en av de träningsanläggningar som...
Hey, I tell you something. It doesn't matter where you are in the world. The military have the same sports halls. There must be a company that goes out and says, yeah, we can design military sports halls for you. They've got literally everything. Look on the floor there. They've got more markers on that than God knows what. But that's a standard military sports hall troops. You're going to be climbing. You're going to be sitting there. You're going to be running, sprinting, playing basketball. You name it. That will probably have everything.
Som finns här på bataljonen. Dels finns det en klätteranläggning, dels finns det ett gym, en hinderbana och i anslutning till kasernen.
Ski track, that's awesome. So when I was up 4-5 commando, we had a ski slope up there. It was called the ski slope. Whether it got used for that or not, I don't know, but it certainly doesn't get used for that now. And yeah, but that's in Scotland, you know, where you can expect to have snow, but that's pretty cool having a ski track and running track on adjacent to your military establishment. That's really cool, man.
Området även skidspår och löpspår. Det här är ingenting som ni kommer att nyttja på egen hand i början. Utan här kommer det inledningsvis genomföras fystester. Därefter kommer ni efter utbildning kunna nyttja det för egen träning när ni är lediga.
Yeah, it goes without saying you're probably not going to be able to use this kit when you're in training. But obviously when you pass, then yeah, you can do it. You want, can't you? Really, it's like, you know, you train soldier and stuff, and the things that you're not allowed to do in recruit training when I was in commando training was crazy. You were so restricted, but it was done for a reason, troops. And when you pass out and you complete the course, if you complete the course, when you get posted to your first unit, the immense sense of freedom that you get is overwhelming to begin with. But then, you know, 4 or 5 years down the line, you realise that you're still restricted in certain ways. But it's for the better, it's for the greater good, you know. It truly is.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is. There's the guy over here. See this person here? He gets about a bit. Let me know if you've punched this person's head in before. This old mannequin here. What's his name? He's got a name. Let me know what you call this guy. We had a name for this guy in England. I don't know if it's a universal name. It's something like Ed or something like that. But yeah, he got beaten up many, many times. And that's a nice top that he's got on there. Oh, man. Yeah. Good times, guys. We didn't dress ours up like this, though. But that looks pretty damn cool. A nice tight top. Here's a question for you guys then, because I'm using translations and stuff from Google to be able to translate certain parts of this video, such as the title and stuff. And it came up, Jäger Battalion is the Hunter Battalion. But then I got corrected on a few of these things, saying that it's not Hunter Battalion, it's not the Hunters, it's the Rangers. Does this still stand with these guys? Is it the Ranger Battalion or is this the Hunter Battalion? Let me know, please, troops, because obviously I don't speak Swedish. And I don't want to offend anyone if I say the wrong terminology, but I believe it to be Ranger Battalion. Is that correct? If not, let me know.
Nu befinner vi oss i serviceförrådet. Det är här, när ni kommer in de första dagarna, som ni kommer att rusta på, det vill säga att hämta all er materiel. Det är även här som ni kommer tillbaka för att byta ut materiel om den är trasig eller smutsig.
Right, tell me this, guys, because this is everyone in the British military will say the same thing as what I'm about to say now, and I want to know if it's the same in Sweden, okay? Stormen, the people who run the stores, okay? You've got, for instance, a pair of boots, and those boots don't work. You've snapped a lace or something like that, and you go try and exchange them boots. Does it feel like you're trying to exchange gold for those boots? Because that's what it normally feels like in Britain. And by God, you can't get anything hardly. It's as if they treat that kit behind the store as their own personal kit. And it's not, it's the military kit. Because Stormen are really, really hard to get anything out of in Britain, and especially in the British military. Is that the same in Sweden? Do the Swedish Stormen don't like to give you anything? Have they got a saying that stores is for storing things and not giving? Because that's exactly the mentality in Britain. Let me know if it's the same mentality over there, guys.
När du kommer som rekryt till arméns jägarbataljon är det viktigt att du är både mentalt och fysiskt förberedd. Förutom att träna är det väldigt viktigt att du är fullkomligt inställd på att din tillvaro kommer bli annorlunda. Både din sociala situation och din förmåga att hantera stress och sömnbrist. Det är viktigt att du kommer hit med inställningen att kunna pressa.
Yeah, it goes without saying, troops, and we've went over this before. Physically, you can get yourself into a state where you can push yourself, you can feel that you're motivated, you can feel challenged, but things don't really bother you anymore because the body adapts so well physically, okay? Physical stresses it just adapts to pretty quickly as well. Mental stress, though, that's a different kettle of fish, and few of our veterans in the chat will be able to let you know that what we think to be mentally strong is not actually what you require in the military. I put it like this. Sometimes you having mental strength, right? What I did is I tended to try and get rid of certain things to be mentally strong. I didn't try and gain things. I didn't try and look for information to become mentally strong. I just got rid of certain things such as missing home and everything else, and emotions, you've got to kind of suppress them a little bit. So I think the mental preparation is the biggest one. If you were aspiring to join Swedish military, or you're already conscripted to potentially join in the future, then definitely prepare your brain mentally, because it is everything, guys, all right? It is everything. You can push your body physically as high as you want, but if your brain isn't up to the task at hand, then physically it doesn't really matter, okay? So I agree with that point. It is important to come with a good attitude, all right?
Ta dig själv, kanske framförallt mentalt. Det är avgörande för om man klarar av jägartjänsten. Det som är speciellt med grundutbildningen här i Arvidsjaur är att det ställs hårda krav på dig som individ att kunna lösa uppgift i mindre enheter under svåra förhållanden. Svåra förhållanden kan till exempel vara den norrländska vildmarken, men också den subarktiska miljön. På AIB har vi två stycken huvudinriktningar av tjänster. Det är jägarsoldater och jägarförstärkningssoldater. Jägarförstärkningssoldater har...
Yeah guys, have you seen how it's obviously it's translating into hunter soldiers? Is that right?
Har en grundläggande jägarutbildning liksom jägarsoldaterna, men är speciellt utbildade i att lösa transportuppgifter, ledningsuppgifter och andra understödsuppgifter i bataljonsram.
What does that video translate to?
Har nu besvarat de flesta
right guys
som du behöver veta i nuläget.
They look like some good videos.
Kommer veta när du kommer hit.
Might have to react to those.
Återigen, varmt välkommen till Arméns jägarbataljon.
Right then, I'm just going to rewind it back a little bit so we can get a better screen behind my head. Right then, troops. So, that was pretty good then. I enjoyed that. I wanted to learn a little bit more about how you guys, you know, a little bit behind the scenes stuff. We've seen what happens in recruit training for the Swedish Ranger soldiers. I want to see a little bit at battalion. What does it look like? What is it expected? A little bit of a behind the scenes experience there. And plus, like I said, it's Sunday, nice chilled video today. We can drink our tea. I've obviously smashed mine right in, and yeah, we can have a chat on Twitch after this, guys, all right, if you have any questions on that. I'm definitely going to be reacting to more Swedish content, one, because make no mistakes about it, a lot of the views at the moment are coming from Sweden, so you guys want to see the content, so I'm happy to give it to you guys as well. However, third point for that, I really, 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 truly am enjoying learning about these Swedish military groups, okay? It's becoming a little bit of a hobby of mine, so what you won't see is off-camera me doing my own research and stuff and speaking to different people in the Discord to gain certain bits of information, because it's really, really fascinating. I've just become a bit of a Swedish historian in terms of the military and how it's developed over the years as well. I think that's pretty amazing, guys, from where you've came from to where you are now. And it's interesting, simple as that. So I'll be continuing to react to these. But as I look forward to tomorrow, we're going to be starting something else as well. So make sure you stay tuned for that one. The way to do it is smash that subscribe button, hit the like button if you haven't already. All the likes for the channel really do help it out. Join the Discord so we can chat together. And we can have, you know, you guys are amazing on Discord, I must say that, all right? I don't even have to put comments in there. The chat is flowing, okay? Really is flowing. And yeah, I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying watching you guys build that community, because it is your community. I might be the Discord owner, but you guys own that community because you're keeping it alive and kicking, all right? But if you want to see me on Twitch after this for a chat, or just to see me gaming and stuff like that, it's pretty good. We're having a good following on there now. The link is in the description, or I might just post it in the live chat as we speak. Click on that, click on Twitch, job done. Happy days. But other than that, troops, if you've enjoyed this video, smash the like button, and I will see you tomorrow for the next one, but I'll see you after this on Twitch. Cool. Happy days, guys. Take it easy.